Well, good afternoon, everyone. This is your roving reporter, Jewel Arden, again. I'm sorry I'm getting a late start on my day, but Daddy and I went to the VA today and did some visits with the gentlemen and women that are there. Today, I'd like to talk about horses in World War I. The use of horses in World War I marked a transitional period in the evolution of armed conflict. Cavalry units were initially considered the best way to go into battle. But because of the type of warfare that was going on in World War I, they actually started to become an obsolete necessity in the war. The military mainly used horses for logistical support. They were better than mechanized vehicles at traveling through deep mud and over rough terrain. Horses were used for reconnaissance and for carrying messengers, as well as pulling artillery, ambulances, and supply wagons. The presence of horses often increased morale among the soldiers at the front, but the animals contributed, unfortunately, to disease and poor sanitation in camps, which was caused by their manure and their carcasses. The value of horses and the increasing difficulty to replace them was such that by 1917, some troops were told that the loss of a horse was of greater tactical concern than the loss of a human soldier. Ultimately, the blockade of Germany prevented the Central Powers from importing horses to replace those lost, which contributed to Germany's defeat. By the end of the war, even the well-supplied U.S. Army was short of horses. Conditions were severe for horses at the front. They were killed by artillery fire, suffered from skin disorders, and were injured by poisonous gases, even though some of the horses even had gas masks. Hundreds of thousands of horses died during the war, and many more were treated at veterinarian hospitals and sent back to the front. Well, it was a very unfortunate part of the war to literally lose millions of horses to help fight the cause. Once again, more unlikely heroes in World War I. Talk to y'all tomorrow. Jewel Arden out.